So, good morning, everybody. Today we are going to have a session on famous fashion brands. So, I have taken four famous fashion brands, जिसमें कुछ ना कुछ बहुत iconic है each brand में. So, we'll just talk about it. I'll just share my screen. Can you see my screen, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So let's start. We have first we'll start with the very basic ki fashion kya hota hai and everything. So fashion means something that is trendy or valued in a certain time or period. It's basically जो भी एक particular time पे जो भी हम जिस चीज को हम value करते हैं या follow करना चाहते हैं उसे fashion कहा जाता है. एक prevailing trend होता है या style होता है, जिसे हम कहते हैं ना, this is in vogue, एक word आता है कि ये सब अभी चल रहा है, उसे हम fashion कहते हैं. Fashion can also be in lifestyle and accessories and cosmetics, मतलब everything जो हम normal के अलावा जो कुछ use करते हैं, जो हमें लोगों से different करता है, हम उसे fashion कहते हैं. Besides clothing, ornaments, accessories, makeup, the way we present ourselves and the way we talk, this all comes in your lifestyle and fashion. We create a certain image. इन सब चीजों को use करके और follow करके हम एक certain image बनाते हैं हमारी society में, जिसे हम fashion कहते हैं. Okay. So why is it important to follow fashion? It is important to follow fashion because हमारी personality और एक personal style show होता है इससे, ठीक है. उसके बाद एक art form होता है कि हम दे हमारा, for example हमें किसी fashion designer का work बहुत अच्छा लगता है, तो हम उसको अपने तरीके से portray करने की कोशिश करते हैं, ठीक है. It is fun because हम कुछ follow करते हैं और उस बारे में debate करते हैं. सबके अलग-अलग views होते हैं, हर एक चीज को लेके, चाहे वो कोई कपड़ा हो या कोई करंट फैशन ट्रेंड हो, क्या कोई ब्रांड हो, क्या किसी सेलिब्रिटी के लुक हो. हम एक सेलिब्रिटी के लुक पे भी बहुत डिस्कशन करते हैं, ठीक है. इसके बाद इंडस्ट्री, फैशन इंडस्ट्री बहुत प्रॉफिटेबल होती है बिकॉज एवरी नाउ एंड देन कुछ ना कुछ न्यू मार्केट में इंट्रोड्यूस होता रहता है, ठीक है. जब कुछ न्यू इंट्रोड्यूस होता है तो एक न्यू ब्रांड का एंट्री होती है या न्यू पर्सपेक्टिव की एंट्री होती है, तो बहुत प्रॉफिट जेनरेट होते हैं. फैशन की हिस्ट्री है और बहुत ही इवॉल्व हुआ है वो हिस्ट्री को लेकर. फ्रॉम वी हैव वेरी फेमस फैशन ब्रांड्स जो हिस्टोरिकल 1950 के टाइम से हैं, जो अभी तक हैं और वो बहुत प्रिवेल हो रहे हैं, और आज के टाइम में जो बहुत पुराना ब्रांड है वो एक लग्जरी ब्रांड कहलाता है. सो इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट दैट वी नो एंड फॉलो फैशन फॉर आवर ओन ग्रोथ एंड इवन इन दिस सोसाइटी. सो आई हैव टेकन फोर मेजर फैशन ब्रांड्स which are iconic in their own very way. Like Coach has its own iconic. Coach का सबसे बड़ा selling point है Coach sells bags. But उनका एक iconic feature है कि वो bag charms बनाते हैं. Hermes है, इसका सबसे famous है उसका Birkin bag और उसका Kelly bag. Louis Vuitton is famous because उन्होंने luggage बनाना शुरू किया था और उनका एक locks, उनका बहुत ही famous lock system है जो उनके handbags और luggage दोनों में लगता है. फिर आता है शनेल. शनेल की सबसे आइकॉनिक चीज है उसकी परफ्यूम शनेल नंबर 5A, बी कोको शनेल की लिटिल ब्लैक ड्रेस, ठीक है. सो दीज टू आर वेरी आइकॉनिक थिंग्स इन शनेल. सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद अर्मेज. अर्मेज इज अ फ्रेंच लग्जरी ब्रांड विच स्टार्टेड इन 1837. इट स्पेशलाइजेस इन लेदर्स. इट क्रिएट्स थिंग्स विच आर लेदर बेस्ड, दैट इज इट्स हैंडबैग्स, wallets, accessories. Now with the recent trend, it has even started to do home furnishings. They do home furnishings, they do furniture, they do leather furniture, they do perfume jewelry, ठीक है. एंड देव बीन इन द बिजनेस सिंस 1837 ठीक है Hermes is ranked 32 in the international luxury market in the top 100 brand list. It comes on the 32nd position. Jo Hermes ka logo hai, it has a duck carriage with a horse. Duck carriage is not a full carriage, but it has, matlab, jaise hum Bombay jaate hai, to niche khali niche wala portion of the carriage hota hai, usko ek duck carriage kehte hai. To Hermes ka logo is a duck carriage and a horse. Okay. Aur iska logo 1950s se chal raha hai. 1937 में Hermes लॉन्च हुआ था और उसके कुछ टाइम बाद इसका जब इट वाज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड एंड Hermes बिकेम अ नेम इसका लोगो इंट्रोड्यूस हुआ एज अ ट्रेडमार्क एंड अ पेटेंट तो इसका लोगो इज अ ड्यूक कैरिज विद अ हॉर्स ऑन अ नॉट अ ऑरेंज थिंग बट फिर ये लोगो इसके बॉक्स पे भी आता है जो भी आप Hermes से चीज खरीदते हो वो एक बॉक्स में आती है और उस ऑरेंज कलर का बॉक्स होता है नॉट अ ब्राइट ऑरेंज बट इट इज अ डल ऑरेंज लेदर ऑरेंज और उसके ऊपर ये लोगो बना हुआ होता है Hermes की हिस्ट्री Hermes began in Paris in 1837 with the founding father Thierry Hermes inaugurated a harness and a saddle workshop providing equestrian riding supplies to European noble houses basically Hermes का जो owner था he made horse riding was very prevalent that time तो जो हॉर्स के ऊपर सैडल्स लगते हैं लेदर सैडल्स जो Hermes का ओनर है वो बनाता था फिर एंड राइडिंग सिर्फ बहुत ही फेमस लोग करते थे ठीक है फिर तो सो विद अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम जब उसने ये सैडल वर्क्स बनाना शुरू करा ग्रेजुअली पीपल जो हाई क्लास पीपल थे वो ही सैडल्स अफोर्ड कर सकते थे फिर धीरे धीरे द फैमिली स्टार्टेड टू ऑपरेट इन द फैशन इंडस्ट्री 1900s में ठीक है जब Hermes के डिसेंडेंट्स ने इसको टेक ओवर किया लाइक अडोल्फ एंड एमिली मुरीस Hermes टुक ओवर द बिजनेस और इन्होंने बनाया एक बैग बनाया जो सैडल को स्टोर करने के लिए था क्योंकि एवरी टाइम आप एक हॉर्स को सैडल नहीं रख सकते तो जब सैडल को आप ओपन में रखते थे तो लेदर यूज टू गेट स्पॉइल्ड सो जब इन्होंने 1900s में बिजनेस टेक ओवर करा तो इन्होंने लेदर को स्टोर करने के लिए एक बैग बनाया तब ये बिजनेस में आए सैडल को स्टोर करने के लिए एक बैग बनाया तब फिर उसके बाद से इन्होंने धीरे धीरे अपना बिजनेस इवॉल्व करा एंड दे स्टार्टेड मेकिंग बैग्स दे स्टार्टेड मेकिंग लिटिल वॉलेट्स एंड विद द एवोल्यूशन दे स्टार्टेड मेकिंग बैग्स फिर 1950s में जब इनका बिजनेस थोड़ा एस्टैब्लिश हो गया ठीक है मतलब एस्टैब्लिश हो गया वेल एस्टैब्लिश हो गया एंड एवरीथिंग हैपेंड इन्होंने अपना लोगो बनाया दैट वाज अ duck carriage with a horse jo unka logo hai it is inspired by a french painter theek hai his name was alfred de drux theek hai and then because that logo was painted on an orange color background that is why inke boxes ka color bhi orange hai iconic orange hai bahut hi dull orange hai wo kyunki us painter ne us orange ko paint karke ye painting banayi thi to unhone same शेड और सेम तरीके से उन्होंने Hermes के बॉक्सेस को वो आइकॉनिक ऑरेंज कलर दिया और वो जो लोगो है वो उस पे इम्प्रिंटेड है सो Hermes इज अ वेरी वेरी ग्रेट लग्जरी ब्रांड एंड इट्स फेमस फॉर इट्स टू मोस्ट फेमस बैग्स एंड इवन स्कार्व्स Hermes वाज द ओनली कंपनी विच स्टार्टेड मेकिंग स्कार्व्स एंड सोल्ड स्कार्व्स एज अ लग्जरी प्रोडक्ट Hermes के स्कार्व्स कभी भी प्लेन नहीं होते हैं उसपे हमेशा एक बॉर्डर होगा और उसपे हमेशा Hermes का लोगो बना होगा या तो Hermes का पूरा Hermes लिखा होगा इनके पेटेंटेड एब्स्ट्रैक्ट डिजाइन हैं जो ज्योग्राफिक जो यू नो एब्स्ट्रैक्ट डिजाइन विच आर अ लिटिल मोर ज्योमेट्रिकल इट्स एन एब्स्ट्रैक्ट डिजाइन बट इट्स अ ज्योमेट्रिकल एब्स्ट्रैक्ट डिजाइन सो दे मेड स्कार्व्स इनटू अ लग्जरी आइटम दे मेड जनरली Hermes स्कार्व्स आर सिल्क But with the recent trends, people like to use scarves more. We wear t-shirts ke saath, everybody wants to wear scarves. They have recently have introduced linen scarves as well. Hermes is doing linen scarves nowadays. Okay, so the philosophy behind the success. The luxury industry is built on a paradox. The more desirable the brand becomes, the more it sells, but the more it sells, the less desirable it becomes. So Hermes ka jo concept hai wo hai ki एक लग्जरी ब्रांड का जो मोटो होता है वो इसलिए होता है कि समथिंग विच यू डिजायर समथिंग यू वांट टू बाय मतलब वन इन अ मिलियन होती है एक चीज बट ये है कि अगर उसको आप ज्यादा खरीदो तो उसकी वैल्यू भी कम हो जाती है. और मैं दिस वन थिंग जो आप ऑब्वियसली बिकॉज इट्स वेरी एक्सपेंसिव वी कैन नॉट हैव सो मेनी ऑफ आवर मेस पीपल डू हैव इट बट ईच वन हैज इट्स ओन क्लास It's classic identity. Even if you buy 3-4 bags of Hermes, you know, you buy 4 Birkins. No, sare 4 Birkins will not be the same. Each one will have a different adjective to it or a different norm to it. Okay? So Hermes has maintained its quality that each product has a unique feature. Okay. Hermes, despite being listed since 1993, has been a family business. The leadership of the company has passed through multiple generations of the owning family, and the DNA of the brand has never been compromised, nor its values, amongst with integrity and quality merch, have never been diluted. Hermes is the only brand. Hermes shares a shareholding with LVMH, 10%, less than 10% of the it shares with the LVMH, but it's always been owned and is taken care by the family. It's always the blood of the family is always there with Hermes. There's no other person who's taking care of Hermes. There's always the line, the family line, which has always been in Hermes. Okay, so they have not compromised on the quality which their ancestors gave. So it is still maintained. Okay, so it has always been there. And Jean-Louis Dumas, the group's iconic chairman from 1978 to 2006, told the Vanity Fair, "We don't have a policy of image, we have a policy of product." Jean-Louis Dumas is one of the iconic chairmen of Hermes. He was the CEO for quite a long time because he helped Hermes reach a point where it is now. He said that we do not believe in too much of marketing because our product speaks for ourselves. He was one of the main mans who helped reach Hermes to the stage where it is. He helped them introduce new product lines in the brand, and henceforth Hermes is where we know it is. In a world where image has been the driving force for many business since at least the 80s, such an approach works as a differentiator for Hermes. Because Hermes has always had a bloodline jo uske, you know, jo usko hamesha own karta tha aur usko chalata tha. Or it has had the best of the best people to make it reach the level it has come. So Hermes ko kuch market nahi karna pada. Uska naam hi uske liye abhi bhi uska naam hi uske liye kaafi hai. Koi Hermes bolta to hume uski ad dekhne ki zarurat nahi padti. Hum apne aap hi visualize kar lete hain ki Hermes bol raha hai to usme kya kya aayega aur uski kya quality hogi ya uska kaise product aayega aur har cheez kaise hogi. जो अर्मेस के जो बुटीक्स होते हैं उनका एक सर्टेन ऑरा होता है. ठीक है, दे स्टिल मेंटेन देयर सैडल वर्कशॉप वाला ऑरा. बाहर से दे आर वेरी क्लासी एंड एवरीथिंग. व्हेन यू गो इनसाइड इट ऑलवेज हैज द यू नो एट वन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम इट ऑलवेज हैव अ सैडल हैंगिंग समवेयर एंड द सैडल बैग ओल्ड आइकॉनिक सैडल बैग हैंगिंग समवेयर बिकॉज दैट वॉज देयर इंस्पिरेशन फ्रॉम विच दे हैव रीच्ड टू द लेवल दे हैव रीच्ड राइट नाउ. Okay, so you have an image of how an Hermes store looks. All Hermes stores have this iconic thing at one side. You can see a saddle and a saddle bag and everything else hanging. This is found in all Hermes stores in the world. Okay, so LVMH is the shareholding company with Hermes, which owns less than 10% of it. Even after being listed, Hermes has maintained its stability. Only 10% of it is owned by a fashion house, that's LVMH, and it's LVMH is the biggest fashion house, as we all know. So this is Hermes success story. Then we have the products. Hermes has leather products, lifestyle accessories, perfumes. It even has clothes ready to wear. But its leather goods add to the revenue of the company. ठीक है, the accessories add to the revenue of the company, and they, like it's written here, they use silk and other textile to manufacture scarves. Silk was the initial manufacturing. Every Hermes scarves were in silk, pure silk.
But now they are saying that it's not audible. It's not audible. Like most people are saying that it's not audible. Just give it a.
Now can you hear me?
Yeah, I think it's audible.
Okay, I'll start again. So the product here is jo Hermes mein silk scarves use hote the, now other textiles have also been introduced and they're even doing fragrances as a matter of fact. But Hermes ke jo key products hain wo hain unke scarves, Kelly bag and the Birkin bag. The picture here, the front bag which is in the smaller size is the Kelly bag. The bag at the back with the bigger size is the Birkin bag, and the scarves are around it. The one with the bow is the scarf. These scarves are also used as the bag decoration, bag charms, and they're also used to be worn. Okay, so this is all about Hermes. Next, we have our very famous Louis Vuitton. It's always easy to understand Louis Vuitton because LV logo is always very prominent everywhere. So it's one of the most famous brands, and its LV monogram is famous everywhere. Matlab, we don't have to tell anybody what LV stands for. You just know what it is. So Louis Vuitton stands 19th in the 100 brand list, and it has it's a worth of $19 billion. So big, and it's owned by its parent company, which is LVMH, and it's the most counterfeited brands because it's one brand which just sells. Louis Vuitton does not even care about marketing; it just sells because of its unique features. Okay, so LVMH has the maximum shareholdings, and because Louis Vuitton is a brand, Louis Vuitton even gives 2% of his shareholdings to its current CEO, whoever is the current CEO. So that is their business tactic, that they give 2% of the shareholdings to the current CEO, who is working at that point of time. Okay, Louis Vuitton is a counterfeited brand in the fashion world because it has a status symbol. It provides products and is amongst affordability to a certain range of people who can afford it. So Louis Vuitton was founded by Vuitton in 1854 on Rue Neuve des Capucins in Paris, France. In 1858, Vuitton introduces flat top trunks with tanyan canvas, making them lightweight and airtight. Before the introduction of Vuitton trunks, rounded top trunks were used. In earlier times, suitcases were round in shape, but with period of evolution, in 1958, Vuitton used a flat top trunk, which it had ropes to tie it up. So those trunks were introduced by him in 1958. Okay, the company participated in 1867 in a universal exhibition in Paris. In 1871, Oyayo Lama Iwao became the first recorded Japanese customer in ordering a set of luggage. So when the company participated in an exhibition, there was this Japanese customer who ordered the very first set of luggage. The same flat top trunks, which were made by Vuitton, they were ordered in 1971. To protect against the duplication of his look, Vuitton changed the tie and design to a beige and brown stripes design in 1876. And in 1885, the company owned its very, very first store in London on Oxford Street. So now, jo hum monogram se dekhte hain, brown ke upar beige se likha hota hai LV. Earlier, it used to be stripes. The flat top trunks earlier were tied. Then, with period of time, because it was easy to copy the design, he did some variations in the trunk. When he was ordered the very first order by the Japanese customer. So to avoid the duplication of the look, he changed the design to stripes, dark brown to put beige stripes. Now the beige stripes have been changed with the LV monogram, but earlier it was stripes. Okay. So with that luggage coming into being in 1885, they opened their very first store in London on Oxford Street. That store is still there. In 1888, Vuitton created the Damier canvas pattern, which bore a logo that read Marque L. Vuitton Dispose, which means Louis Vuitton Registered Trademark. This was when they started to write Louis Vuitton on their luggage bags. The luggage was as big as it was. So instead of the stripes, they started writing there Louis Vuitton registered trademark, so that people could not follow it, could not duplicate it, and hence it became the name. Okay, now because LV Monogram, they still have this luggage available. This is the most expensive luggage available in Louis Vuitton. It still comes in the darkest brown, which has with beige written on it, the same Louis Vuitton registered trademark. So, philosophy behind your Louis Vuitton success. So, Louis Vuitton Melletier was a suitcase maker who established his French luxury brand in 1854. He focused on the high-end market and was well known for his great designs. The designer was therefore given the honorable task of creating special luggage for French Emperor Napoleon III's wife. Then it was in 1896 that Louis Vuitton introduced the famous LV monogram to his bags, the design which has become so famous today. So after his establishment, after selling in the exhibition, he even made the luggage for Napoleon III's wife in the same brown pattern. And in 1896, he introduced the LV monogram, which is now till now famous and is the same. Louis Vuitton introduced some of the most famous bags in the world, which is the Speedy bag and the Neverfull tote. The Speedy bag is a normal bag which is in this shape. It's an oval shape. And Neverfull tote is the normal tote which is open from the from above and has strings to tie it. It is the Neverfull tote, which is the most selling, fast selling bag of Louis Vuitton. It's on the high end, price is on the high end, but it's just a simple tote, but it's the high, then they call it Neverfull tote. In 1997, the brand started to design women's clothing, and 3 years later, expanded to men's clothing as well. Today, it's a billion-dollar company selling not just bags, but also clothes, shoes, watches, jewelry, accessories, and perfumes. So, in 1997, they started making women clothing, and then men clothing, and today they are the brand, and they sell almost everything you require. That will be clothes, shoes, watches, jewelry, accessories, and even perfumes. From day one, quality has always been at the core of every single Louis Vuitton product, and the strategy pays off. Louis Vuitton has never compromised with its quality, and till date, everybody counts on their quality. Louis Vuitton doesn't do marketing. They just create products that are exceptional in their design and craftsmanship. Every bag made by Louis Vuitton is individually handmade with the utmost care. And even though the company now operates on a very large scale, they still know how to maintain the small company feeling. Everything till date is handmade. That is why each piece is unique. That's why I told you, now these brands don't do marketing. They just make a product and the product speaks for itself. They do not require to make an ad. You don't see all these big brands doing ads on TVs or newspapers. They don't do it because they don't require it. Even when we don't see their ads on TV, we know what product is there. That is the impact they have created in the past year, that we don't have to know. I don't have to know ki Neverfull tote kya hai ya Louis Vuitton kya hai, kaunsi perfume aati hai. इनकी कोई एड नहीं आती टीवी पे, कोई रेडियो पे हर 2 मिनट्स बाद कोई एड नहीं आती, इंटरनेट पे गूगल पे कोई एड नहीं आती, बट वी नो व्हाट द प्रोडक्ट्स आर. दैट इज द इंपैक्ट द ब्रांड्स क्रिएट. ठीक है, एवरीथिंग इज वेरी एक्सक्लूसिव बिकॉज वो हैंडमेड होता है. कैन यू प्लीज म्यूट योरसेल्फ समबडी. Okay, so exclusivity is another secret to the success of the brand. Louis Vuitton has always tried to counter mass production with short-term limited edition series. This means that not everyone will own the same bag, and means that those who do get their hands on a limited edition bag get fantastic exclusivity. Louis Vuitton does not do mass production. it does not believe in mass production or anything. So what it does is it makes a set of bags. Maybe it makes one kind of bags, which are 10. So 10 people might have those bags and the other 10 people will have a different kind of bag. So it doesn't do mass production. It creates a line. It creates a product line which replicas of 10 and 15, and only those are there in the same category, not more than that. Hence, which makes them exclusive. Ki out of this, I'm getting that there are only 10 bags in India, ye wale, ya, 10 bags in the world, and this person have it. So it's very exclusive. Louis Vuitton keeps on inventing itself and is successful because it adapts to the need of the customer. Louis Vuitton knows how to innovate and stay true to their classic traditions at the same time. Through numerous collaborations, the brand has worked with artists and designers such as Jeff Koons, Takashi Murakami, Pharrell Williams, who have all created their own limited edition lines. These series helps the brand to connect to the new and the younger audiences. Louis Vuitton has always been very successful because it realizes what the current customer wants. Thus, they link up with celebrities to make a specific line only for those celebrities. So some of the same famous lines which have been selling very nicely is the Jeff Koons, Takashi Murakami, and Pharrell Williams. Pharrell Williams is, as you happy, and you know that happy wala song singer. So he has his own line of shoes and even has crossbody bags from Louis Vuitton. Okay. So the simple but elegant LV monogram is recognizable all over the world, but it's the combination of quality, exclusivity, and innovation that makes a perfect recipe for a timeless success. We don't have to double check when we see an LV monogram, unless it's a first copy, of course. But when there's an LV monogram, we know that's Louis Vuitton. It's recognizable all over the world. Matlab, kisi bhi kone mein ho aap world ke, aur aapko pata hai wo LV, aapko pata hai wo sirf Louis Vuitton ho sakta hai. Uske alawa aur kuch nahi ho sakta. So the quality and exclusivity is such that makes a brand successful. Okay. I'm sorry, just a minute. Okay. So these are the key products. They do luggage bags, shoes, watches, jewelry, accessories, and perfumes. The key products are LV luggage and handbags. So you can see the entire luggage collection, which is in the top. And there is some Indian bride getting out of the car who has LV luggage. So some motivation. So this is the patented LV monogram, which is being used. The same, this is the traditional luggage which was earlier made, which had the stripes and the flaps. This is the same design. This is the most expensive luggage you get in LV. The sides of these luggage, where you can see the golden sides, they are all gold plated, and pure leather is used to make these luggage. The other female who's holding a bag is, this is the Never Full tote bag, which has strings to tie up. This is the most fast-selling bag of Louis Vuitton, and it's a huge bag. It's huge, it's a tote, and it's amazing. So these are the two key products which are highly sold. And yeah, that's there for Louis Vuitton. Next is Coach. Coach is iconic. There is one similarity here. Coach and Hermes have a similar logo. There is a very very small difference in it. First, that Hermes has a duck carriage. This has a full carriage, and here the logo is facing towards your left hand side, and Hermes the logo faces towards your right hand side. Okay, and the person is standing in front of the horse. The person is riding the carriage. So they have a similar logo, but obviously both of them sell good bags, of course. So Coach is basically a US based brand, which is even called as Coach New York. It's an American company which has luxury accessories and handbags. And earlier, Coach was owned by the Coach company, but recently they have changed their mother company as Tapestry. Coach has been named Tapestry now. It happened in 2018. And Coach basically started as a brand because they realized that everybody wants to follow fashion and become stylized. So they started making bags which were affordable to a certain sect of women, you can easily have different kinds of bags to use for every occasion. They opened with that concept, and with period of time, it became a luxury brand. So Coach was founded in 1941 as a family-run workshop in a loft on 34th Street in Manhattan with 6 leather workers who made wallets and billfolds by hand. The Coach factory still exists in the same location. They still make bags there where they started off. In 1946, Miles Kahn and his wife Lillian joined the company. Miles and Lillian Kahn were owners of leather handbag manufacturing businesses and were knowledgeable about leatherworks and business. The Kahn people here used to make big bags of leather. Because earlier, after the World War and everything happened, big bags, duffel bags were in fashion. So people used to carry them because they were easy to hold on the back and even to, you know, take from one place to another instead of big boxes and everything. So these people used to make leather bags. But because they knew about the leather business, so they joined the same company. In 1950, the Kahns took over the company and strategized to expand the business. So in 1981, the company opened its first directly operated retail location on Madison Avenue in Midtown Manhattan. They have their store there. Coach has a store in Midtown Manhattan, same very location. So when they started opening, from the big bags, they started to make wallets and then started to make normal leather bags. So philosophy behind their successes, talk about the most sought after fashion brands in America, we will find ourselves end up quoting Coach. Coach, when we talk about Coach, we know USA, and when we talk about USA, we know the famous brand is Coach. Coach is one of the most famous New York based brands company, which deals based fashion company, which deals in providing various luxurious leather goods and accessories to people. Coach is most commonly known for the products related to women, such as gifts, apparels, accessories, which include handbags, footwear, outerwear, and ready-to-wear, etc. In the year 2000, one of the partners named Sara Lee sold 19.5% of the shares of the Coach to an IPO. It was followed by the distribution of the remaining shares through an exchange offer. The logo was introduced in the year 1959. So, after the Kahns took over the company, with the period of time, there were many people who were responsible for taking Coach ahead. So Sara Lee was one person who wanted to establish the business very much. So she sold some parts of the shares to a fashion house, which helped in providing funds to increase the Coach business and make it into a luxury brand it is today. Coach is one of the most leading company in the field of fashion and luxury. This company has provided and served at their level best for the people, especially for women, to get access to the best fashions of all times. Coach earlier started with a very affordable price because every lady wanted a handbag and everybody could not afford it very much. So Coach was at that time had a nominal price of leather handbags, because earlier they used to make only leather handbags. So Coach was there, but with period of time as well and evolution, Coach also ran into the race of luxury brands, and now it's one of the most expensive bag brands you can find. So being in the business for Coach was all about sticking to what was latest and what would be made affordable to the lovers of fashion. So there are a couple of iconic Coach bags. Like here you have a Coach bag which has an entire C insignia on the bags. Then you have other which has a normal Coach insignia with their brand logo. And there is the middle bag has an embossed logo with a charm, with their famous dragon charm. Bag charms, I'll come to that in some time. So Coach was basically came to the idea of luxury with, you know, affordable luxury. Coach was basically called affordable luxury because people who could not afford big bags like, you know, like Hermes and Louis Vuitton, Coach was easier in their approach. People could afford Coach easily and, you know, have whatever fashion bag trends were there at that time or whatever accessories and everything else was there at that time, they could, that would be an affordability in Coach format. Maybe shoes, perfumes or that time. Coach became a little different when it introduced bag charms. So they, bag charms are like the ones here, the horse shaped charm here. Coach, this is an extra line of product which Coach does till date. It does bag charms. You even have those fluffy charms which you get in, now you get in certain bags in Aldo and accessories wala brand. But Coach was the Coach was the brand who started the concept of bag charms. Their famous charm is this horse charm because there's a horse in their logo, and the other one is the dragon. They have a dragon made in the same form the horse is made. There's a dragon. And that's the charm. And it is in green color and purple color, the dragon. I could not find an image. But that is a dragon charm. Plus, they started off with the box purses. Coach was the one who started off with box purses, like you can see here. It opens into a complete, the box opens completely. The box opened completely. And they even started off round sunglasses recently. And yeah, so this is all about Coach. It was not a luxury brand earlier, but with the period of time and evolution, has become a very famous luxury brand. Because of, and it, what makes it different is it is the bag charms they make. So next is Chanel. Chanel is famous for none other than because of its Chanel number 5, the perfume, which we know very clearly. But Coco Chanel is the person who started off with the Chanel brand. Okay, and with the period of time, she was a mistress to a person, and she started working in her, she started making hats earlier and sold it to the royals and the aristocrats. And then that is when she started to kickstart her brand. And gradually we know where Chanel is right now. So let's just go about it. Chanel is a French privately held company owned by Alain Vertimer and Gerard Vertimer, grandsons of Pierre Vertimer, who was an early business partner of the couturier Coco Chanel. Chanel is a luxury company that focuses on high fashion and ready-to-wear clothes, luxury products and accessories. In her youth, Gabrielle Chanel gained the nickname Coco from her time as a Chantenouse. Chantenouse is basically an exotic dancer. As a fashion designer, Coco Chanel catered to women's taste for elegance in dress with blouses and suits, trousers and dresses, and jewelry of simple design that replaced the opulent, over-designed and constrictive clothes and accessories of the 19th century fashion. The Chanel product brands have been personified by male and female fashion models, idols, and actresses. So, Coco Chanel's real name was Gabrielle Chanel. She gained the nickname Coco from her time as a Chantenouse, who's an exotic dancer. And then, with her name of Coco Chanel, she started the brand, which catered to the tastes of women with elegance and started with dresses, blouses and suits, and with the period of time became very famous. Chanel's history. The House of Chanel originated in 1909 when Gabrielle Chanel opened a millinery shop at 160 Boulevard Males Herbs, the ground floor of a Parisian flat of a socialite and textile businessman, Etienne Balzan, of whom she was a mistress. She was a mistress of this person where she started her first flat and socialite, she started off with a shop, millinery shop. Because the Balzan flat also was a saloon for the French hunting and sporting elite, Chanel had the opportunity to meet their demi-mondantine mistresses, who as such were women of fashion, upon whom the rich men displayed their wealth, as ornate clothes, jewelry and hats. So, because she was a mistress to this very famous person, who even had a saloon where he used to sell French hunting and sporting elites. So at that time, having a mistress was a fashion for all men. So when people used to come with their mistresses there, Chanel had an opportunity to sell the hats she made, the clothes she wanted to design and jewelry. So at that time, hats were a very famous fashion for going out for a ceremonial purpose. There used to be different hats for going out for a normal luxury of leisure wear. There used to be different kinds of hats. So everything like this had different kinds of hats. So she started selling hats. So she designed handmade hats and sold them to these mistresses of famous people. Okay, and thus started to make her name. Coco Chanel thus could sell to them the hats she designed and made. She thus earned a living independent of her financial sponsor, the socialite Balson. Coco Chanel in 1910 opened her first independent millinery shop, Chanel Modes, at 21 Rue Cambon, Paris. So while selling hats, she became very independent. And in 1910, she opened her first shop in Cambon, Paris. In 1921, to complement the suit of clothes, Coco Chanel commissioned the perfumer Ernest Bjork to create a perfume for La Maison Chanel. So after that, when she created hats and everything else, she met this perfumer, used to make perfumes and everything. So he had a perfume which was called Number 5. So with the period of time, because she liked it a lot, it was called and named Chanel Number 5. Earlier, when people used to buy from Chanel, Chanel No. 5 perfume was given as a gift to the clients. But because it was liked by everyone so much that now it later on came into the retail store. In 1923, to explain the success of her clothes, Coco Chanel told Harper's Bazaar magazine that design, simplicity is the keynote of all true elegance. And we still use her quote that simplicity is the keynote of all true elegance. The Chanel logotype comprises two interlocked opposite letters C, one face left and one face right. The logotype was given to Chanel by the Chateau de Cremart. He's a person who was that time a blog. Now we call them bloggers, but he was this person who used to write. He used to write about whatever, because that was not the time of women to become famous and strong. So he was this person who used to write about famous women. And he was called the painter of personality through pen. So he gave the logo of Chanel and then of two opposite C's because of Coco Chanel. And because she was a Chanteuse and then she became a very famous designer. So he placed both the C's in the opposite direction and they met at some point of time. And they intercircled at some point of time. So he gave this logo to Chanel. So the success of Chanel, one of the most influential designers of the 20th century, Coco Chanel was born in Saumur, France in 1883 on August 19th. Her sense of sophistication and taste for best and luxurious apparel placed her among the most respected as well as graceful stylish icons. Her timeless design suits, especially her trademark product Little Black Dress, are still prominent among stylish women in fashion. Every girl today always has a black dress in her wardrobe because of this reason, that little black dress. They say a little black dress never goes wrong. The first success came from the idea of creating loose and relaxing women's dress she fashioned out of an old jersey on a chilly day during 1920s. And very soon, the tight and stiff clothing became very impractical and old-fashioned and in the old-fashioned world. So she came with an idea of comfortable clothing, and with the period of time, people realized that comfortable clothing is more important than, you know, tight fitting corsets and everything which people have been wearing from a very long time. In 1920, she launched her most famous design, Chanel's Little Black Dress. 1920, Little Black Dress came into the market and she launched it. In 1922, Coco Chanel introduced her first ever perfume mix of natural extracts and artificial essence named Chanel No. 5 to the global market. In 1925, she launched the graceful legendary Chanel suit with collarless jackets and well-fitted skirt, which became a revolutionary product for the time in her designing career. She became a very famous icon in the Paris literary as well as artistic worlds and got designing offers from reputed names. So when as soon as she introduced her Chanel suit with the collarless jacket and the well-fitted skirt, she was the first person to introduce skirts with suits. And with period of time right now, we have blazer and skirt sets available in the market. She was the first person to do it, though we have collar lapels now. But yeah, she was the first person to do it. In 1926, Coco Chanel designed and launched the little black dress which was nicknamed as Chanel's Ford by French Vogue. So the little black dress's basic name, the fashion name is called Chanel's Ford. After the launching of the little black dress, Chanel got very much in the powerhouse aspect, where it launched so many other things with it and became a luxury brand. Coco Chanel was primarily responsible for developing the concept of applying jersey fabric to create and adorn clothing for women undergarments. Earlier, there used to be very cotton and very stiff undergarments, with the period of time. So Victoria's Secret CEO also says that we got our inspiration of making stretchable and breathable lingerie from Coco Chanel because she introduced a different fabric to be used for innerwear. The stylish, flattering cut, simple but pleasing fabric and gracious look of Coco Chanel suit made it so famous and perfect choice for women. So after her black dress and Chanel No. 5, her Chanel suit was so famous among people. So the people, to the women who wanted to feel strong and wanted, they all preferred wearing a Chanel-made suit called the Chanel's Ford. The brand Coco Chanel is best known for outfit jewelry, quilted stylish bags, two-toned shoes, and simple suits of jersey. So they're famous for their quilted bags. Always Chanel's bag is quilted and they have this geometrical or abstract designs on them. They may be the tote bags or normal crossbody bags. They have two-tone shoes, even if it's a white color shoe, they have a different tinge of white by which their logo is imprinted on the shoe. And most of their clothes are made in jersey fabrics, which is breathable and comfortable. So you have some famous iconic products here. We have the Chanel No. 5. We have the Chanel hat, which has the Chanel logo. And we have the Chanel shoes, which have a design to it. And we have two kinds of Chanel bags here. Each of them is quilted with geometric designs on it and have the famous Chanel logo on it. So that's about our four famous brands. And if you have any questions or doubts, you can please ask me. Anybody has any questions?
No, ma'am.
Okay. No questions? Ya to sab kuch samajh aa gaya ya kuch samajh nahi aaya. तो ये चीज हो सकती है.
You don't want to speak, आप चैट बॉक्स पे लिख सकते हो अपने क्वेश्चंस. इट्स दैट इजी फॉर यू.
चैट बॉक्स में लिख लो अगर आपको बोलना नहीं है तो. I don't think there are any questions. So,
somebody else asked.
Okay, Ayush, she's asking, I want to start my brand, how to start my own label. See, first you have to, I don't know if you've attended my last session on marketing. I told you that time also, you have to establish a business. When you establish a business, you do a label. When you make your label and your label is famous, then it becomes a brand. So first you have to do your market survey on what business you want to do. आप उसमें क्या products डालना चाहते हो, आप क्या बनाना चाहते हो या क्या sell करना चाहते हो. उसके बाद आप उस product से inspiration लेके आप अपना label बनाओगे कि मेरा label ये है और मैं इसमें ये sell करेंगे. उसके बाद जब आपका लेबल मार्केट में एस्टैब्लिश होता है फिर आपका ब्रांड बनता है. ठीक है आयुषी, फर्स्ट यू हैव टू थिंक अप आपको क्या बनाना है, आपका क्या बिजनेस है.
श्रुति, यू रेज्ड योर हैंड. श्रुति, if you don't want to ask, just write it down on your chat box. I think that would be more convenient. If you don't like to ask. Muskana has asked something. Pallavi, if you can read.
Ma'am, although LV or the brand like this don't need any ad now, but what was their initial step? Okay, that's a very good question. Muskan, what happens is the same thing I told. They started off with a very small thing. They started, jitne bhi LV or top brands hai, not only all these four brands, but other famous brands, they all started with the concept ki hum ek aisi cheez banayenge jo ek insaan ko chahiye, you know, what jo market study ke according hai. And unhone kisi ne bhi उस चीज से शुरुआत नहीं करी थी जो वो अभी सेल कर रहे हैं. उन्होंने वही शुरुआत करी थी जो उनके उस समय अराउंड था. अगर आप लुई विटॉन से लेते हो तो उन्होंने भी स्टार्टिंग में किसी और चीज से शुरुआत करी थी. या आप अर्मेस लेते हो तो उन्होंने सैडल बनाने शुरू किए थे, हॉर्स सैडल से बैग तक का सफर है उनका. सो यू नो यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज अराउंड और व्हाट इज योर अवेलेबिलिटी एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. They sold what was there. With gradually अपना business बढ़ाने के लिए उन्होंने different चीजें धीरे-धीरे try करी. तो वो भी 10 years में इस जगह पे नहीं पहुंचे. उनको भी ऐसे 20-30 century लगी है, तो दूसरी century चल रही है. पिछले century में उन्होंने शुरू किया था, इस century में आके वो हैं जो अभी हैं वो. ठीक है, so they started off with their limited resources and starting. और उस time में तो ads होती भी नहीं थी. So, उनकी प्रोडक्ट की क्वालिटी ऐसी थी कि एवरीबडी वॉन्टेड टू बाय देम. सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल ऑफ आप अपने रिसोर्सेज से क्या बनाते हो और आपकी प्रोडक्ट की क्वालिटी स्पीक करती है आपके उस चीजों के बारे में. ओके मुस्कान, एनीबडी एल्स? Any other question, anyone? Hello ma'am, people think about my company or product, what are the feelings and associations I want them to have? Are they unique? Can we own them? Ayushi, when you are establishing a business, there are two important things you have to keep in mind. First, you should know what product you want to make, and second, the product you want to make is going to be acceptable in the market you are staying. Okay, so if both of them are in harmony, then it will be easier for you to know ki aapke customer ki kya feeling hai uske according. Okay, agar aapko pata chal jayega ki aapka customer ke wahi need aur want hai jo product aap bana rahe ho, तो आपका बिजनेस एस्टैब्लिश होने में ज्यादा प्रॉब्लम नहीं है और आप एसोसिएट कर सकते हो उस चीज को लेके. लेकिन अगर आपका प्रोडक्ट और मार्केट हैंड इन हैंड नहीं जाते हैं तो आप ना तो उसकी फीलिंग समझ पाओगे ना उसका कोई एसोसिएशन होगा. अगर आप चाहते हो कि आपकी कंपनी और प्रोडक्ट यूनिक हो तो आपको वेल वर्थ स्टडी करनी पड़ेगी कि आपके अराउंड आप क्या प्रोडक्ट बना सकते हो जो एक्सेप्टेबल होगा. ठीक है, सो यू कैन नॉट ओन योर कस्टमर्स अंटिल अनलेस यू नो व्हाट हैज टू बी गिवन टू देम. ओके, सो अंटिल अनलेस यू नो कि कस्टमर को क्या चाहिए और आप उसको कुछ और दे रहे हो जो उसको नहीं चाहिए, तो आप कभी भी कस्टमर को ओन नहीं कर सकते. तो देयर विल बी नो कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ब्रांड लॉयलिटी हियर. दे विल नॉट इवन लाइक टू कम एंड विजिट यू. ओके, एनीबडी एल्स? We know it's necessary to understand international brands and all about them when we are learning fashion design. My question is, can you elaborate any of Indian designers and how they started? Very seriously, I'll tell you one thing. Indian designers have not established themselves as brands. You do not hear any Indian designer saying, I have this brand. They always say, I have a label. Because their statute is not to the extent what these brands are. So there is no Indian brand as such which has established itself. The only Indian brand which has established itself is Khadi Udyog. That is the only Indian brand. Okay. So if you talk about bigger fashion designer, Indian fashion designers, Sabyasachi doesn't say I have a brand, he says I have a label. Manish Malhotra doesn't say I have a brand, he says I have a label. And they don't have a brand store, they have a flagship store. Okay, and flagship store is not a store which is owned by you. It is a rented place where you put your products. See? Okay, so none of them is a brand. So the only Indian brand which is there in the international market is the Khadi. You're welcome. Anybody else?
Ria raised her hand. Ria? Unmute yourself and ask question. Okay, somebody asked question on chat.
Yeah. Can you tell me the marketing consulting company released its ranking of the top global brand of 2020? Okay, so Malika, you can visit Economic Times ka fashion retail section, Economic Times newspaper. Open it, go to the fashion retail sector, and you will find the top global brands of 2020. But they will give you the information of the financial year, because our 19-20 financial year has not yet been fixed because of the corona. But you will have some idea of which is the most expensive brand. According to me, Nike is the most expensive brand as of now, because it had around $28 billion before we closed for corona. $28 billion. Okay, so you can see in the Economic Times. Any other question? I guess not. Ankita, should we end the session?
Yeah, I think so. Nobody is asking any questions.
Yeah. I think they've understood too much. Yes. Or nothing. Let me just take the positive aspect of it. So we'll end this session.
Thank you so much, guys. Thank you for joining.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, Pallavi. Thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you. Okay, bye-bye.